I had a few questions from two of my YouTube followers, and they regarded this circuit. I published it quite a long time ago, many years ago, and it is on my YouTube channel. It was originally a so-called storm detector. The schematic dated out of 1962 from an old electronics magazine, and I made it more modern and used two silicon transistors. This is the whole circuit, and the claim from the circuit was that you could receive lightning strikes from far away, and also jet engines. You could hear electromagnetic noise generated by jet engines from far away, and I think that could be 10 or 20 kilometers or so anyway. So it received in the very low frequency band between, say, 1 kilohertz and 25 kilohertz or 30 kilohertz, and it had a tank circuit at its input and then two transistors, and I made it with silicon transistors with a better amplification factor compared to germanium transistors from 1962, and I made the amplification variable with the help of these two potentiometers in the emitter lead. The questions regarded the coil. I made that coil originally on a wooden frame of, say, 33 centimeters with a few hundred windings on it, with from thin enameled wire. And of course we know that this is a tank circuit. A coil bridged with a capacitor is a tank circuit that is tuned to a certain frequency band, and that's important. I also made it with a ferrite antenna coil with a ferrite rod, and here you see that drawing, and all these things here mean that that are sections from very thin it is made from very thin wire with sections in between, and that's important to tell. This is an old video. As far as I know, I didn't publish it on YouTube. And here you see that coil here, and when we look close, you can see these sections from that thin wire, and it's made with a cardboard roll. And the ferrite rod can be moved in and out that cardboard tube. And that's very important to tune the coil to a certain frequency in that low frequency band, somewhere between 1 kHz and 30 kHz. And this is the capacitor that bridges that coil. So I want to play that old video now. And here I focused more on the coil. You can see these sections again. I didn't have a very good camera in those days. And here again the circuit made with a tube. And that's also the reason why I made this circuit more simple. Because the 6088 tube is perhaps not easy to find. They sold them on eBay in those days, as far as I know, and that's why I made it with two transistors like the original schematic from 1962. Here are all kinds of explaining how it works, etc. So this is one circuit, and perhaps important to tell, I also made it with a field effect transistor, and we know from a field effect transistor that it has a very high impedance on its gate, and that is the reason why I used it. It's a very sloppy drawing, sorry for that. I made it somewhat too quick, but you can surely find out, see how I connected that field effect transistor in the circuit. It's a source follower. And in fact, an impedance transformer. The amplification is not dramatic from that field effect transistor, but it transforms the impedance at the input from that coil properly to the following circuit. Though I have to say, it is not very important because we work now on extremely low frequencies. So in fact, you can compare it all to what an audio amplifier does. A normal audio amplifier that goes from say 20 Hz to 20 kHz. This is the better drawing of the field effect transistor part of this circuit. Very easy to make, and you can also use this for all kinds of other radios. In fact, it's an active antenna. And I've published it earlier on YouTube, but perhaps for radio amateurs this could be interesting. And the BC547B can go to 9 MHz. So in fact you have here now an active antenna that can work from VLF to say 9 MHz. And of course a better ID use here in that case a typical high frequency transistor, a BF type. But anyway, this also works good. And I was tuning in that old video the coil. Perhaps I can find it, that part of the video. Don't want to make this video too long. Anyway, I think I was tuning the coil here. And there's a somewhat better video where here you can see kind of tuning. I'm searching for the peak resonance on VLF. So that was it. This is the easiest circuit that, in my opinion, always works.